This video presents how to create so-called 360-degree panoramic renderings using ARCHICAD's built-in R19 CineRender engine developed by Maxon. Such renderings are more and more popular and supported by various common online platforms and social media portals as well. More and more mobile phones and tablets can also be used to take 360-degree photographs. Let's see how to create such renderings in ARCHICAD. Let's use this interior scene for demonstration purposes. It is important to place the camera around the center of the scene we wish to render. In this case, we must place the camera close to the center of the room. The camera Z and the target Z values must be identical. In other words, the camera should be looking straight ahead. Let's display the photo rendering settings dialog and enable detailed settings. Let's enable the spherical camera option and review the available settings. Using the FOV helper, we can choose between equirectangular or dome options. The equirectangular option will render the entire sphere. The dome option, on the other hand, will render only above the horizon. The equirectangular mode is recommended to be used in most of the cases. The mapping option describes how the 360-degree image will be handled. Here it is recommended to use the lat long option because this is supported by most of the platforms. In certain specific cases, we might need to use one of the cube map options. We will discuss these later on. It is recommended to leave the fit frame option unchecked. The use full range option, on the other hand, should be checked. This will cause the generated render to consider the entire sphere. 360 degrees in the horizontal plane, longitude, 90 degrees in the vertical plane, latitude. It is important to set appropriate frame sizes for the rendered spherical image. We must specify 2:1 image ratio when rendering the entire sphere. 800 by 400 pixels are way too small, so it is not recommended to use such low resolution for a final spherical render. We will use this size only to illustrate the rendering options and settings and to be able to produce spherical image examples quickly. Let's use these settings to render the first 360-degree scene. The rendering process has been started, and it will take 2 to 3 minutes to create a spherical rendering with these settings. Please note that the final image slightly distorts certain parts of the original scene, horizontally and vertically as well. If we would stretch this image on the internal surface of a sphere, we would see a correct 360-degree image. A final stereoscopic rendered image should be at least 10,000 by 5,000 pixels. This size corresponds to the entire 360-degree scene. The details of the spherical scene will not be displayed properly if we use a low resolution. The final rendered image can be saved as a standalone raster image file, for instance, JPEG. Please note that the quality of this image is much better than the previous, however, the distortion is still noticeable. The spherical rendered image must have the appropriate Exif image metadata before uploading it to an internet or social media portal. CineRender adds the standard Photosphere XMP metadata to the saved image. However, this might be extended or modified depending on the actual requirements of the various portals and platforms. Please read about such requirements on the social media platforms you wish to use. In case you have to edit the EXIF information of the generated spherical render, you may use a free, third-party EXIF editor application, such as EXIF Tool. This is available for both Macintosh and Windows platforms. After adding the required Photosphere XMP metadata, stating that the projection type is equirectangular, the spherical photo can be uploaded to social media platforms. Please check out the EXIF tool description and the exact requirements of the various online platforms regarding the necessary EXIF metadata to be added. Here you can see the uploaded spherical rendered image. This image can be viewed on both desktop and mobile devices such as smartphones and tablets. Let's return to the photo rendering settings of ARCHICAD to check out some additional spherical rendering settings. There are three additional cube map mapping options available to choose from. Certain applications and platforms use one of the cube spherical mapping options. Such mapping options will generate 6 standalone square images. Using any of the cube spherical mapping options requires defining a 4x3 image size, because the 6 square images are created on a 4x3 area. In this example, we will use an 800 by 600 pixels image size, but please note that this size would be way too small for a final spherical rendering. Let's render the scene. As you can see, the spherical render is created on the 6 faces of an imaginary cube around the camera. This spherical render will look very similar to the previous one, because the engine of the online platforms will create a smooth and continuous image using the 6 square faces of the imaginary cube. The other two cube map mapping options will also create similar rendering results.